The Welsh politician said the European Union's obsession with its three key Brexit issues is causing unnecessary harm to businesses on both sides. Speaking to RTUK, Mr. Gill said what we're seeing really is this posturing over these three points that don't matter in the scheme of things. We really need to be thinking about is, if this is a divorce bill, who are the children? Because in a divorce you always look at the children, and I think what we need to consider is that the businesses of Europe, the people who make money and who trade are the children. They are the ones who need to be looked after in this process. Europa Pressrtuk Mr. Gill said EU attempts to delay Brexit talks are harming businesses on both sides. UKIP MEP attacked stubborn EU negotiator Michel Barnier for refusing to move forward with talks on future trade arrangements with Brexit Britain, saying the Frenchman needs to get on with the negotiations. He continued, if I were a manufacturer in Germany who sold primarily to Britain, or I produced my wine in France and wanted to sell to the British market, I'd be very annoyed at Michel Barnier right now for being so stubborn. So Barnier, get on with the job or move over for somebody who will. It follows yet another run-of-the-mill round of negotiations in Brussels between Mr. Barnier and Brexit Secretary David Davis. Meanwhile, EU Commissioner Jean-Claude Juncker revealed Brexit will take longer than both sides initially thought. He drew laughs from a crowd at the University of Luxembourg as he repeatedly said Britain must pay its financial obligations to the bloc, comparing its actions to a drinker refusing to buy a round of beer. The EU chief, who notably switched to English just for the Brexit-related section of his speech, insisted he was not in a revenge mood and that the European side still wants to secure a good deal with the UK. He said Brexit is a serious issue. It came now, unexpected but not totally unexpected. They have to pay, they have to pay. Not in an impossible way, I'm not in a revenge mood, I'm not hating the British. The Europeans have to be grateful for so many things Britain has brought to Europe during war, after war, before war, everywhere and every time, but now they have to pay.